At this point, we either have a video that works or we don't have a video that works. So can somebody who can see back there tell me whether we have a video or not?
Unfortunately, I wasn't able to video the first award winner, Eugene Hubert, who came to the U.S. and developed catalytic cracking in Paulsboro, New Jersey with Noble and Sacconi. Loving Hubert, he founded OxyCat, which was a forerunner for today's auto exhaust, and the picture shows him with an early exhaust catalyst. The first award was the Emmett Award for excellence in academic research in catalysis. Emmett is a perfect role model for this award in that he excelled in research. His results are just as accurate today as they were when he developed them. It might have stood the test of time. I was able to get 6 one-hour lectures Emmett gave at Oak Ridge National Lab, and an example of his ability to handle questions is shown.
Could you elaborate a little bit on the statement you made whereby the hydrogen in your lanthanum lethal compound is denser than it is in normal liquid hydrogen?
This is a statement that's tricky to me, but I wasn't satisfied with the statement, so I calculated out the density of LaMI5H5, the 5 hydrogen stuck into the 5 nickels. And the density of these materials goes up, I guess, to the range of 6 or 7 grams per cubic centimeter. And it just turns out that if you take a mole of this material, which will have 2.5 moles of hydrogen, and calculate out the space that it occupies, and the space occupied by liquid hydrogen, that this statement is true.
Professor Michel Bernard, like his professor, Sergeant Taylor, was a very organized and original scientific thinker.
We have a continuum of ideas to perform all examples of various functionality sensitive connections. The best example of the structure sensitive connection, which we have been able to find, is the ammonia synthesis.
Professor Robert Burwell was a true academic researcher and excelled in designing catalysis experiments.
How would you describe Sergeant Taylor?
Well, they're very prosperous. First, he was a very busy man. He had usually lots of things going on. But nevertheless, he came to the laboratory every day once. And the standard graduation view was that if you could show him a graph, he would be happy.
Francis had to move through a number of industrial positions to become Vice President of Research at W.R. Grace. In that position, he started the North American Catalysis Society meetings. For 100 years, Irvin Winder has excelled in research and management.
Can you describe some of the people at the Bureau of Mines when you were there? Keith Hall, Milt Lane?
Well, I can enjoy the Keith worked with Bob Anderson, and Bob was in charge of physical experiments for the Wings. A whole series of physical reactors lined out. Fellow named Floyd Schultz, who worked with Climate.
Thank you indeed, Bert, for recording the history for those of us who were not there to see it ourselves. I'd like to call back to the podium one of the chairs of this meeting, Dr. Pender, to take over the meeting at this point.
Thank you, Enrique. I promise to keep it short, and I'll keep to my promise here. Thank you, Andy, for setting me up here. I think one ship, one captain was the luck on the Titanic, so luckily we had quite a different ship here. We had a big crew, and everybody worked together really well. Clicking the statistic, you already heard it. We had an overwhelming response. We had over 1,400 registrants for this meeting, which created some issues. We've burst in from the seams, but I was very lucky to hear that actually those who went to the Westmoreland room weren't banned to that room. In fact, we were oversubscribed. We had to turn people away who wanted to go to the Westmoreland room. So thank you, everybody down in the Westmoreland room. I hope you're still with us there. We had 1,250 applicants. We had 1,250 abstracts, 3 plenaries, 21 keynote lectures. Can we get this list back? Thank you. 463 oral presentations, 588 posters, and overall, I think a fantastic, lively program. Thank you to all the presenters, 49 exhibitors, and not to forget, 36 sponsors overall. There you go. And maybe I can ask for a moment all those representatives of the sponsor companies to stand up and get acknowledged, because without their generous support, a meeting like this would simply not be possible. poster program chairs. I think, unfortunately, Elise Fox and Cindy Deng already left. But Yanni Korpakis is here again. Posters, a big part of our program. We had very lively poster sessions this year again. Again, we talked a lot about the next generation. These are really the next generation. Carlos says, Rob Rio, Felicite, and Nata Sakaba couldn't be here tonight. Okay, and while we are on the topic of caucus share, there you go. I would like to acknowledge we have 110 caucus awardees more than ever before from several universities in the US, Canada, and Mexico. And I was desperately looking on the web for a photo of Richard Caucus, but somehow he seemed to have escaped the all-grasping reach of Google. But when you Google Richard Caucus, you find all these photos on there. And I thought it's maybe a better attest to his legacy than anything else. These are all former caucus awardees who still proudly display this award on the webpage. Probably some of them are in the room, so maybe I can ask all former caucus awardees to get up and get acknowledged. Almost done, but now come the real organizers of the meeting. I would like to say even more gray hair, but I guess there would be even less gray hair without the wonderful, wonderful team from Meeting Solutions, Jennifer White, Jill Pepper, Penny Moorhead, and Katie McNeely. Last but not least, obviously, a thank you to all the reviewers that helped us to review, again, I mentioned it, delivered 3,435 reviews. It's a gigantic task, it wouldn't be possible. Obviously, most of you are in the room right now. And thank you also to all the presenters and the participants who really made this an outstanding meeting, or at least so I've heard. I didn't see a whole lot of it. Thank you all.
So this is the last time that you will see me at the meeting. I would like to call the other two chairs of the meeting to come off the podium and join us. I am absolutely sure that I speak with the grateful voice of this community in thanking the Pittsburgh Cleveland Catholic Society for being such gracious hosts and for the dedication and effort that has made us so comfortable during our stay here. I remind everyone that you will be called to serve, and that when you are called to serve, you are expected to serve with the same dedication with which you have been served. That is the deal. So I would like to recognize the three meeting chairs. I have to say that it has been a pleasure and a privilege to work with you. Actually, more accurately, to watch you work. And in a token of appreciation, and in order to avoid being followed for the next 6 years for forgetting to do this, I would like to present each one of you with a certificate. All right, thank you very much.